Hey you guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm gonna do an affordable quick weave, a protective or glueless quick weave. I know y'all hate when I say that, but it's glueless because I'm using the Grow Protect on her hair, so no glue will actually touch her own hair. It's a barrier in between the hair and the glue. So anyway, I've already used the Roberts Diamond Bun Grow Protect on her hair, and I let her go under the dryer for about 15 minutes. Now I'm just gluing her cap down because I didn't put it on while the Grow Protect was still wet. So I'm just gluing the cap around the edges, and I'm gonna start laying the tracks. Now this hair that we use is very affordable, very inexpensive. It's Milky Way New 3-piece deep, and it's in the 8-inch, and it's in the color 530. This hair been around forever and ever, and my friend has a hard time doing anything to her hair that requires curling or wrapping or styling at home. So she wears a quick weave usually, and she needs something that's easy for her to manage, so she gets this hair here. So anyway, I've put the Diamond Grow Protect on her hair already, let it dry, and now I'm just applying the tracks. So I just started off by applying the tracks in the back by the nape, and I'm going up over the ears, and here I'm just adding some tracks to the back for extra fullness. Okay, and now once you're done applying the tracks in the back, you just want to go side to side over each ear and just apply as many tracks as will fit in that space. So you just want to keep applying side to side until you run out of space, and then use your blow dryer to make sure the hair is totally dry and laid down. And then you're just going to start doing shorter pieces on that fuller side. So you just do shorter pieces until you get to the bang area. Once you get to the bang area, you're just going to cut pieces to fit in that space that's left. So you're going to go the opposite direction and just start laying the tracks toward the face once you get to the bang area. I know that sounds confusing, and I'm sorry, but you just want to start laying the tracks forward towards the face, so that you can start forming a bang. Okay, so you just want to continue applying your tracks until you run out of space on the stocking cap. And then you're going to take a little bit of spritz or holding spray and just spray it on the cap area and blow dry it. Then you can proceed to cut the cap off once you've blow dried the cap. Now you're still going to have to add at least one more track here in this space, and it'll be okay to put glue there because remember, you put the Grow Protect on the hair before starting the quick weave. So it'll be okay to lay one track on the hair after the stocking cap is cut. So you just want to measure out a track that fits around the leave out. Blow dry. You might want to add a little extra spritz to that section just to make sure it sticks down really well, or reinforce it with a little bit of glue on top. Then you're going to move on to the leave out. I sprayed a little bit of the heat protectant on there. I think that's Silk Elements, the coconut kind. And I just sprayed a little bit on there and also put a little bit of oil on the leave out. And I'm just going to take my small Babeless flat irons and just put like some little curls in the leave out, because I'm trying to blend the hair into that, to the weave hair. I'm trying to blend her hair into the track hair. So I'm just going to put a few little curls in there just so that the hair can kind of blend in with that hair easily. And then you just want to part it out. Her hair is really fine, and I'm going to show you what I do if a client has fine hair and they're wearing tracks, glued in tracks rather. I'll show you that in just a minute. But anyway, I'm using the shining gem. Excuse me, y'all. I'm using the shining gem. And I'm just going to lay her edges down with the shining gem. And I'm also going to make her a little bit of baby hair. So you make the baby hair the way you like. I'm going to do mine the way I like. If you don't want any, you don't have to. You can just kind of just lay it back, slick it back or whatever. Or just a little bit of baby hair, a lot of baby hair. Whatever you like, that's what you do. So anyway, I'm just going to kind of carve out some baby hair. And then like use the end of my rat tail comb to try to like perfect it or whatever. Like make sure everything is perfectly swerved. So just do the baby hair however you like to do it. Okay, so I'm trying to blend her leave out into the track hair. So I just sprayed a little bit of hairspray and I'm taking my blow dryer and just kind of pressing it down to make sure that everything is laying really sleek and flat. So I'm just going to take a little bit more of the hairspray and I'm just using the blow dryer to lay it down. Okay, this right here trick is for people with kind of like thin hair. So I use the High Beams Jet Black hairspray and I just spray a little bit, not a lot, just a little bit on her part, and also it gives it a crispy, clean part. So I just use my rat tail comb, the metal one, not a regular one, the metal rat tail comb, and I just spray it and it gives it a crisp part and there is no scalp showing. So anyway, I'm taking my Tool Science flat irons. Because this hair is so short, I have to stretch it out a little bit. So I'm taking my Tool Science 1 1/4 inch flat irons and I'm just stretching out this fuller side, the side with the most hair on it. I'm just stretching it out a little bit so that it won't be so short and we can get that kind of asymmetrical bob look. So anyway, I'm just using some regular little hair shears or scissors that you get from the beauty supply, not any good ones. And I'm just cutting in a downward motion and I'm just gonna cut it down. And what's happening is letting me leave the top part of the bob fuller and get closer and shorter at the bottom. So anyway, you're just gonna use the scissors and just cut down. So anyway, I'm just going to take the scissors and just cut it all the way around the hair, just shaping it up all the way around, giving it that asymmetrical bob look. I'm just going to trim out the bangs a little bit, try to shape the face a little bit. She ain't going to wear her hair like too extra in her face anyway, so I'm just trying to get everything kind of even and where to flow and work well with her, because she is not gonna want to have to do any styling to it once she leaves me. So here I'm just taking a little bit of oil and just adding it to the actual track hair so that it looks moisturized and not dry, and just kind of finger combing the curls. Then I'm just spraying a little bit of hairspray because, like I said, she does not style her hair at home. She puts a bonnet on and get up in the morning and go. You know, she might have to shake it out or something, but that's it. So I got to spray a little bit of hairspray just to kind of keep everything in place. Okay, so here I'm just taking my edgers and just kind of trimming out her hairline because I did go kind of high in the back. So I just want to trim and make sure none of her own hair is like hanging down or none of that weave hair. Make sure everything is even
in the back, and then I just took a little scissors and trimmed it up just to make sure none of those hairs was sticking down, that it was all like rounded off in the back. So anyway, I'm spraying a little bit of oil sheen on it, some olive oil, just a little bit, and here's her finished look. I hope you guys like it. This is a quick and easy quick weave, protective style, glueless quick weave, or whatever you would like to call it. If you still here watching this video at this point, I suppose you love the video. So please make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. And don't forget to click that notification bell so you'll be the first to know whenever I upload a new video. Thank you guys for watching.